Get over yourself. Maybe not you. Maybe the person sitting next to you. Maybe you know someone like this. I've known a couple of people like this in my life. And, you know, by all due respect, everyone is entitled to their own feelings, emotional state, and so be it, okay? Every human being is entitled to whatever they want to entitle themselves to. But as I stand here today, I say get over yourself and you know who you are. Get over yourself and you know who you are. Do not be petty. This is what I don't understand sometimes with the humankind. When you make a plan for someone, or let's say you have an event coming up and you inform people and those people do not RSVP, or those people contact you and let you know that, hey, you know what, I won't be able to make it, or you get some kind of communication well ahead of time, whether if it's within 20 hours, but you get some kind of communication, and then you still have the nerve to pout after you've received communication. Get over yourself. The world does not evolve around you. I don't understand how people can actually get upset, like get mad. Now, hear me out. I understand if you're like 12, 13, 14, I mean 18 maybe, and your dad said he was going to come pick you up or something like that, or maybe he said he was going to take you shopping, or there was a commitment and he didn't show up. Hey, totally cool. I get it. I see the base of the emotion. I'm not judging everyone's emotion, but now I'm talking to adulthood. Now, let me tell you something. No mankind is obligated to doing anything for you. I spend most of my time writing and talking about this because I find it interesting when people talk about the pettiness and I cannot believe her. Can you believe her? She did not show up in my baby shower. She said she was gonna be there. What happened to her? Well, she said she overslept. Well, she says she couldn't make it. But why would you personally get upset? Why would you even allow every single nerve and every single little artery in your body to get so worked up because someone did not show up to your event? Don't get me wrong. I understand. I understand that event is significantly important to you. I've had important events. And I've had events where people did not show up. I've had events where I wanted certain individuals to be there and they did not show up. But I just chose not to take it personal. Because I'm a person that understands one thing, that people are people. And this is Ashana saying, Muvanu Vanu, people are people. What does that mean? It means that people have so much going on in their lives. It's not always all about you. So don't take it personal. Don't get upset. If someone does not come to your event, if someone does not honor your commitment, it's not a personal vendetta towards you. So stop assuming, stop having a presumption or a perspective or an intuition, on the reason why they did not show up. As long as you understand that we all are on this earth and we are all in with different struggles and different triumphs, then you have to understand that when someone doesn't show up to your bridal shower, even to your wedding, to your birthday party, to your kid's birthday party, to your mom's funeral, to your father's funeral, to the most important and most significant moments since your graduation, if people or someone in particular that you invited does not show up, it is not a personal vendetta towards you. It's not personal. So do not get upset. Don't get upset over it. Understand that sometimes they might have had something going on with them. There's so many things that go on with people that we don't understand. I've been around people that I did not know suffered from depression for years because I'd always been in their presence, but I don't know what they battle at home. And I'm not insinuating that's the reason why certain people don't show up to events. I'm just saying we cannot be the judge. We cannot judge people for not coming to your event merely because we want to be selfish and we want them to be at the event. We don't know what's going on with that person in that moment. Maybe they don't have enough guests to make it to your event and they don't want to tell you that. We don't know what people are struggling with. And heck, maybe they just didn't feel like it. Can we give them that? Is that okay? Is that okay for someone not to feel like going to an event and not coming or texting you or calling you? And even if they don't call and text you, are you going to live? Yeah, you're going to live. You're going to wake up the next day, right? I hope you will. So understand, it's not all about you, boo. It's not. Get beside yourself. Dust your hands off. Rub your shoulders off. And say, it's not all about me. Have a good time wherever you are, because mankind will fail you one way or the other. It's not a negative condensation, but it's just the honest truth about our human nature that's flawed. I'm so sick and tired of hearing people become so petty about stuff. Oh, she did not show up for my tea time at 4 o'clock. Girl, bye. If you don't stop,